Let's begin. Actually, I should begin with addition, okay? But this slide start with subtracting. Okay, because addition and subtraction is quite similar in the modern processor, because it is a two complement number system, so we can change the positive number to negative number by, if you're looking at the bit binary pattern, you just inverse. So let's say the number six in binary is 110. Okay. So how to do if we change into minus six? So further, we just change the become negate or inverse the binary bit. It become 001. Okay. Just ignore the leading zero first. It becomes 001. Then you add one. Okay, because it is two complements, and you have to shift the minus zero. Right? So you inverse and then add one. And it go up a little bit. So is 110 become 001 plus one become 010. Okay, so it's 010, as you see here. All right. So now we know about the magnitude, and how about the sign? All right. In this case, sign is on the left, right? One be inverse. Okay, it become all the one. The leftmost or the sign bit on the left, the positive number is zero and the negative number is one. But if you want to subtract it, easiest way is to change one number into negative number, and then using addition, you can add them. We have, say, 8-bit system, right? Oh, it's not easy to write with your eyes on the screen, okay, to draw. Anyway, so we have, say, the total number is 226 different number that we can use 8-bit system to represent. Okay, so we divide it in two parts, right? So we delete the total number, half of it, boom. Also, this is positive, this is negative. So the first number is 0 to 127, right? And this is to be minus one. So you can, the best way to fully understand it is to try some number, right? Okay, let's say if we want to add two and three, in two is 1, 0, three is here. And if it's 8-bit, then we can fill in 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Right. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Boom. We can add, right? Very simple. 1, 1 is 0, and then carry one. Then there is this become number 5 in base 10. Have to be three subtract by two. Okay. Three subtract by two. We can do the same. Let's say number 3. Okay, I will ignore the leading bit first. Let's not ignore it. Let's put in the full 2, right? And number 2, let's use this space, number 2. Okay, number 2. We want to produce minus 2, right? Minus 2. Then we inverse this bit 0 to 1, 1 to 0, and then add 1. Wow, inverse bit. And we have to also put in the leading. Become okay for inverse, right? Become this one, and then plus one, it become boom, boom, right? Okay, so is this number become minus 2, right? So we add number 3 with this number. So it's 0, 1 and R1. Let's see what happened. So we add it together, it become 1, right? It is and carry with 1 and then we propagate, right? Because it's all 1, 1, 0, 0, 4 equals 0, 0, 0 all the way, right? So it actually have the correct result, not surprising, but this is how we work out the two complement add and subtract. Okay, so next is we are talking about the if the number is then greater than the length of the bit that we have in the textbook is 64 bit. Right? In our example, it's 8 bit. Okay. So 8 bit, the maximum positive is 127. The maximum negative is minus 128. Right? So let's say you have 200, then it's overflow. Okay, so the, when the two number, let's say, let's talk about adding first. The two number add together, if the result can be larger, right? Because say each of them have the same width, let's say the 64 bit, then when they add together, it may, the result may be larger than 64, then overflow occur. However, if one number is positive, one number is negative, when two add together, the number will be smaller. So there's no overflow. So you can check the sign. Okay, the leftmost we can say if the same sign being add together, then it may have overflow. If the different sign is impossible to have overflow. Okay. The compiler, when we program the machine, we always use high-level language. So the compiler have to be able to generate the proper code to check the overflow condition after they perform arithmetic. Okay. So let's say if we do addition and both operand are positive number, then overflow might occur. All right. So you can find it. Even the first hit explosion of Area 5 on June 1996. Yeah, 10 years, 14 years ago. Right? Okay. Once we finish with add and subtract, we just do multiplication. The easiest approach for multiplication, the current hardware do not perform very simple operation like this, right? Because it is quite slow operation, but we use this one and then I show you a bit of improvement how it can run a bit faster. Right? So let's say we use a number which is easy to recognize. So if, even though it's base 10, but if it's number 1, okay, here, right? Then multiply the multiplicand. You got the 100 here. And the next digit, right? You have to shift, okay, to the left, right? Because it's a next digit, next digit, next digit. Right? Because it's 0, then there's nothing, right? So it's 0. The next is again, 0. The next is 1 again, so here. So with all this, you add everything together and you got the result. It is how we can build the actual circuit to do multiplication. And of course, you can recognize the multiplication contain many steps. So basic design is just imitate the step that you see previously. So we have the multiplicand, remember multiplicand, the first number, and multiplier, the second number, okay. So what we do for the multiplier, we want to know each digit on the right hand side, so we have the multiplier shift right to get the digit out, okay, whether it's one or it's zero. And these digits come here as a control. Okay, this control doing the shifting of multiplication, okay, to the left. Okay, so when we shift the multiplier, we get one digit. Okay, we see if it's one, then we copy the multiplication and add into the result, right? And once we shift the next digit, we have to also have to shift the multiplication to the left. Okay, so this is just ALU, it's just the adder, it's just add, right? So everything 128 bits, because the if we have 64 bits, okay, so when we multiply, it becomes 128 bits. How long it take? Let's say we shift multiplier right to inspect the digit, then we have to shift multiplicand left, okay, and then we have to add. This is a simplification. So let's say it takes 3 steps for one digit of multiplier, and there are 64 digits of multiplier. So more than say 64 by 3, right? 192. Okay, it is improve a little bit to make it a bit what compared to the first version. Multiplicand is reduced to 64 bit. All right, so we are not shifting the multiplicand. Now we are shifting the whole product. The multiplier, checking the digit of multiplier, also disappear. Initially, we have the multiplier in the product, okay, and the result on the left, and then we shift the whole product. Rather than shifting the multiplicand to the left, we shift the whole product to the right, because the product is we use 129 bit. So we can, for free, right? We put the multiplier there, because every time we shift to add the multiplicand, we actually shift the multiplier out of this product register. And doing that, you can see this blue line is that digit, right? To control whether we want to add multiplicand or not adding, it's just shifting. Reduce the multiplicand from the 128 bit register to 64. We reduce the ALU to 64. You can see the detail how the chip and add product works on the step by step on the figure below. Okay. You can simulate, okay, these steps using your high level language, and the number represented as an array of numbers 1 and 0, or the string of number 1 and 0, and then you see that you can, because shifting and other thing you can simulate in software quite easily. Divide, okay. The similar idea to the multiplication. Let's do the longhand division. Okay, so we have dividend, okay, the first number, okay, and the second number is divisor. We have dividend and divisor, and the result have two parts. Okay, we know about this because we have done in the elementary school, the quotient, okay, and then the remainder, okay. The relationship between these four numbers is dividend, right? So the first number that we want to divide is the similar to the quotient multiplied by divisor plus remainder. So let's come into detail. What really happened here? Okay, we have dividend, and then we have divisor, and then we put the number down and then subtract it. Okay, so we have this small number. The next digit down, okay. The 1 1 0 1 0 here, right? And then we do the divisor again. Don't you think the hardware of division look somewhat familiar. Yeah, it must be very familiar because it looks almost the same as multiplication, right? Just reverse, okay? Because the quotient shift to the left. Okay, and the divisor shift to the right, as you see on the long hand, yeah, divisor go this way, right? And the ALU doing the subtraction rather than the addition, okay? And the result is a remainder, okay? I think dividend initially store the dividend, okay, the number, the starting number that we want to divide, okay? We keep it in a remainder, yeah. Is it quite similar to the improved version of the multiplication as I mentioned, okay? So we get these small bits of the to control. Okay, right now we see the organization of the actual circuit. At the high level, not the logic gate level, okay. And you can follow quite similar step to the multiplication. That's why I asked you to do simulation of the multiplication step. Once you understand that, you will go through this without any difficulty. Okay. Quotient is starting with zero, okay. And the divisor is 2, okay, right? Now we have a 4-bit version, okay, so it's not too long to demonstrate. And the right hand side is all 0, okay, and this is the divisor, okay, because divisor will be shift left, shift right, shift right, shift right 4 times, okay. So it starts with the right hand side of all the divisor is all 0. Remainder is the 128 bits result, right? So we put in the dividend, the starting number there, right? Because the starting number will be shift until it go out. Okay. So it's number 7 is there, okay? And on the left is all the 0. You say pointed it. Yeah, so 10010 is here, right? With all the blank 0 here. Because if you shift, go right that way. If you shift right, that way. And the remainder, we have the dividend, the starting number, number 7 on the right hand side, and the left hand side is all 0. Okay. And the quotient starting with all 0. Similarly, we can improve a little bit where almost exactly the same as the improving of multiplication hardware. This is just to give you a rough idea. If you can work it out in detail, you can fully understand it. Good. If not, well, If you know how to write what we call machine language to do division, right? Correct result of some arithmetic that require division, then it's okay. I will ask you to be able to do step-by-step multiplication, all right? Because I think that's fair enough. Although it's a bit step-by-step detail, but not confusing, all right? If now we have the negative number, what we do? the first three lines say, if the same sign of the divisor and dividend, the result, if you both positive and you do division, the result will be the same sign as the both of them, right? Positive divided by positive, the quotient will be positive. negative divided by negative, the quotient will be negative. So if the different sign, then the quotient will have to be what we call negative. All right. To see that this rule is correct, let's see this following example. The invariant, the actual fact is dividend equal quotient multiplied by divisor plus remainder. Okay, so let's use the previous example about 7 and 2. All right, so let's say if we divide 7 by 2 and both of them are positive, right, then we have positive 3 plus a positive remainder 1. This is obvious. Okay, then we can check the result. Okay, dividend 7 equal to quotient 3 multiply by divisor 2, right, plus the remainder. So yeah, it's correct. Okay, right, so if 7 and 2 are positive number, and all this show you that result is correct, so the sign is correct and everything correct. Now let's say we have the -7 divided by +2, and then we have a quotient 3. Okay, let's check. So it become -7 -6. Okay, so this become +6 and then -1. So the remainder is -1. Okay, right. So and if you check the result of the formula, it will be correct. To remind you that, hey, even simple arithmetic is not that simple when you want to design the circuit that give you correct result in every situation.